Hi everyone, I'm Rincy and this is Rincy Reads. Today I'm going to be doing a review on Land of Love and Drowning by Tiffany Yannick. Now, I received this book for free from Book Riot. This was the August pick for the Riot Read, which is a monthly book club type thing. Basically, if you subscribe, you get a book in the mail each month, and then there's content that's created around that book specifically for subscribers. If you're interested in that, I'll leave a link down below in the description so you guys can check it out. But I did receive this book for free so that way I could read it and create content for it. This story takes place in the Virgin Islands. It spans from the early 1900s to about the mid 1900s. I believe it's like 1910 to 1960 or 70. And you're mainly following this one family throughout a couple of generations. The majority of the book focuses on these two sisters, Annette and Iona, and they are pretty different from each other. When the story begins in the 1910s, it's basically when the Virgin Islands goes from being a Dutch territory to being an American territory. And Annette has been brought up as sort of this upper class girl in the Virgin Islands. Her father is a captain of a very major ship. But then by the time Iona is born, a lot of stuff has changed and a lot of really tragic things happen to the family. And so they've been brought up in two very different worlds, and so they have two very different views on life. And you basically just follow them as they grow up and you see all of the choices that each of them makes and how that ends up affecting the rest of their life as well as the lives of the people around them and their future generations. This is a super interesting book, and I feel like I haven't really read a lot of books that are like this. The way this book is written, it forces you to read really slowly, and I don't mean that in a bad way. I feel like because it takes place in the Virgin Islands, the writing is very atmospheric. You kind of feel like you're there, like you're sitting on a beach. You can hear the waves crashing and you can feel like the warm breezes. There's just so much description that's put into this book that you can't really rush through it, and the story is really complex, so there really is no way to read this book quickly. Like, I feel like this is a book that no matter how you read, you have to read slowly, otherwise you're not really reading the book. The story is broken up into different chapters and the perspective switches back and forth between different characters throughout the book. Most of the time you're either in Annette's perspective or Iona's perspective, or sometimes like a third person narrator type perspective, but sometimes you do get glimpses into the perspectives of other characters as well. And it's really interesting to see all of that because their lives all kind of diverge and then come back and intertwine again and then diverge again. So you see a lot of different things happening, and you sometimes get to experience scenes from different point of views. This is a book that basically everyone in this story could be categorized as an unlikable character. Like, I feel like everyone just makes poor choices or are put in positions where they're basically forced to make poor choices. But I feel like even though all of that was occurring, I still had a lot of sympathy for these characters. Like I said, I feel like most of the time they're just put into situations where their only option is to make a poor choice, or the only thing that they know is how to make poor choices. Like, they had past experiences that have really changed or guided the way that they make their future decisions. So it all kind of makes sense, like, why these horrible things happen. But at the same time, it doesn't make you happy or isn't necessarily something that you like. It's just one of those situations when you read it and you're like, well, that's just the way it is. And I know that's going to be a difficult thing for some people to be able to take, so I just wanted to put that out there. I don't necessarily want to say that this is a book for everyone because it is a difficult read. There's a lot of really difficult topics that are discussed in here. There are things like rape and incest and things like that that happen in this book, and it makes you kind of uncomfortable sometimes to be reading about it. I feel like if you have read Toni Morrison, you might like this book. And there are elements of magical realism in this book as well. And it reminded me a lot of Gabriel Garcia Marquez. So if you read his books and really like them, I feel like this would definitely be up your alley. But if you don't like magical realism, I know that there are some people out there who really don't like those elements, then this probably would not be the book for you. Again, a lot of the situations that happen in this book, you just kind of take it as it is what it is, and then you move on from it. There isn't a lot of like explanation or things like that. So if you're looking for answers, a lot of times this might not be the book for you. In the end, I gave this book a 3 out of 5 stars on Goodreads. This is probably be more like a 3.5 for me because it's good, but it's also really difficult. This is a book that I feel like would push almost everybody outside of their comfort zone. So if you're looking for something along those lines, I would definitely recommend this book. I can't really say that this is, again, a book for everyone because I know for a fact that there are going to be people out here who don't like this book because It deals with a lot of difficult topics. The writing, while it's beautiful, isn't easy to digest. But I do feel like this is a book that a lot of people who watch this channel would really like, because you guys aren't afraid of difficult and challenging books. So yeah, that's my review of Land of Love and Drowning. If you've read this book, feel free to leave your comments down below. I know a couple of you guys have said that this is kind of on your TBR pile, so if you've read it, let me know. If not, let me know what you are expecting or what you think or anything like that. Or if you have any questions about this book, feel free to leave those down in the comments as well. So yeah, that's all I have for now. Thanks for watching.